going to talk about problematic characters and what a problematic character is and why we love these problematic characters.
Crow, or Yo It's Crow on Twitter, is running a problematic fanzine that will be out next month and features a wide selection of characters with differing personalities and motivations and arcs. I'm sure fans of both characters would be riled up if you said Vriska was a lot like Gamzee, for example. So what connects these characters? What makes them all belong in the same discussion? What makes a problematic fave? The dictionary definition of problematic is constituting or presenting a problem or difficulty, which is just about as vague as is appropriate for the way the term gets tossed around in real-world conversations and fandom conversations. In fandom spaces, problematic can mean this character was once an asshole to the good boy protagonist, to this character literally murdered hundreds of people. We have that same wide range in Homestuck. Several of the Homestuck problematic characters are just creepy and vaguely racist. Equius and Cronus are the first who come to mind there. Then we have characters who commit literal murder, like the favorite Murderstuck trio, Vriska, Aridin, and Gamzee. We have a child abuser, a character who commits genocide, characters who manipulate others for their own gain, and just straight-up fascists. Wow, you might be thinking, some of those just sound like straight-up bad, if not evil, people. Why call them problematic? And that's a good question. So good of a question, I'm not sure there's really a solid answer for. So I'm just going to explain it how I personally think of it, which may or may not be correct. But hey, this is my podcast. I do what I want. Homestuck is filled with characters who do shitty things. No character is exempt from doing shitty things. Part of it definitely has to do with the fact that the main cast of the comic is composed of teens. Teens are still figuring out how they fit into society, how they relate to others, what's acceptable, and basically how to be a functioning human, or troll, or cherub, or whatever. So the story is already about how to overcome shitty behaviors, especially ones instilled upon you by society, and becoming a better person in the end. But there are characters who remain morally gray, whether because that's just how they are or they die too early on, so they remain problematic. And to include the epilogues, there are characters who didn't overcome their negative traits and instead grow into them. These, for the most part, are the problematic characters. Sure, some of the characters we deem problematic don't fall into these categories, but I think for the most part that's what we have. Characters who never got to positively grow. Characters who remain morally gray or downright bad. For those of you who don't like problematic characters, or maybe have some in mind specifically you don't like, you may think I'm being a tad too lenient. And maybe I am, but this is a lead into why we like these characters. For some, it's not that deep. They like shitty characters, and that's okay. Bad or evil or irredeemable characters are fantastic, and there's nothing wrong with appreciating them. But as I was alluding to, for others it has to do with recognizing their troubled backstories and seeing a potential for growth, or maybe seeing who they used to be and wishing they could go back to that. And if I may project, some see their own problematic behaviors in these characters and latch onto them, maybe in an attempt to appreciate in others what they can't appreciate in themselves. So, what's the point of all of this? The point is that it's fine to like characters that are problematic or just downright awful. Those are still often well-written, three-dimensional characters, and it's fine if you even relate to these characters in some ways. They're going to rankle people, sure, and you'll have to deal with people shit-talking them, which you may be cool with, depending on the character and your relationship with them, but you shouldn't have to deal with people shit-talking people who like those characters. I'm really glad our fandom is continuing to grow and create, and I'm glad we have a zine specifically dedicated to appreciate characters who, for the most part, don't get a lot of love, or characters people are even hesitant to express love for. I know the fandom is full of drama,
maybe especially on Twitter, which I'm currently most familiar with. So I hope we continue to see projects like this to bring us all back together. These characters are what make Homestuck, and every character is going to resonate with someone in different ways, and we're going to latch on to different parts of different characters. And we even have issues where you might see one thing as problematic that another person doesn't see, and some of those characters may have ended up on the zine and some of them may have not. And it's good that we can have these different opinions and these discussions, and it's good that we can appreciate things that maybe not everyone else can. And I'm always fascinated how every time I think I don't like a character, someone will post meta, or someone will post a fanfic, or someone will post something that just makes me realize why people appreciate that character, and I do too. Not to their level necessarily, but I don't think there's a bad character in Homestuck that is without the ability to like in some way or the other. They're so great. The characters are practically what make Homestuck, and to say that some are just not worth caring about is ridiculous. They're all worth caring about in a variety of different ways. And yeah, I want to see more like the problematic zine. I want to see people say their opinions about characters without it being a huge fucking deal. I want people to say, I love this character, and not have to have a dissertation on why that character is problematic, and they can just love the character. I just know this fandom can do a lot better. And sure, we have our downs, but I'm hoping our ups will be more frequent and last longer. And, you know, I feel like this is a revival. I feel like we can do this. We can come together and make something great. And especially with the What Pumpkin team we have right now, it's in our grasp. And loving shitty characters is part of that. And I feel like I'm going off complete topic from problematic characters to talk about this. And I don't know. I just have a lot of love for this community, even when we mess up. Just like I have a lot of love for problematic characters, even when they mess up. I'm sure if you follow me on Twitter whatsoever, or even are familiar with my Twitter handle, you know what problematic character I'm talking about. But yeah, and I'm just going to take the time to say that I'm sorry. I had a whole series planned on this where I was going to get people on to talk about their fave problematic characters. And I was going to combine some of them because there's so many. Technical issues happened. The first episode didn't go out. I have a whole big explanation that I haven't written yet. But by the time this episode comes out, I will have written on my Patreon. And I'll link that here just so you guys know what's going on, because I want to be upfront and let you know, because I'm not perfect. Stuff happens. That's life. That's humanity. So I really appreciate you guys sticking with me. I appreciate some of the more recognition I've gotten in the fandom so far, which is kind of blowing my mind. So I'm so glad to be here. I'm so glad that we have problematic zines, and just we're allowed to just love the characters we love. And I don't know. I'm bad at endings. I just want us to have a good, fun time. And just to remind you all, I do have a Patreon, Socially Anxious Dragon. I have a website, jackstudshomestuck.com, that has links to everything, and everything is linked below. But I noticed on Spotify that those aren't actually links. So if you want those links, you have to go to jackstudshomestuck.com. And I don't know, I have a lot of feelings about this podcast and about the support I've gotten from this podcast and my friends. And I know some of you have filled out my survey, well, not really a survey, my form, if you want to get on the podcast, and I have not responded to you yet, and that's going to all be explained in the Patreon post, but I will get back to you. And if you have not filled it out and you have a project or something you really want to talk about, please fill out that form and I will keep you in mind, whether it's going to happen in the next couple of weeks or the next couple of months. You're there. You're on my radar. Anyway, I feel like I'm just rambling now. I just want us to be a great community because I've gotten so many friends through this and I feel lame because I'm 28 and I'm just now getting my first real solid online friendships. But this community is great and I can't wait to see how much further we're going to go with it. I'll see you guys next week and I hope you're having a great one and I hope you continue to love what you love.